This morning's Mass is offered in thanksgiving on the 21st birthday of Faith Souls. Also for the repository soul of Brown Williams and the repository soul of Lenten. The first Sunday of Lent begins with a reflection on the temptation of Jesus in the wilderness. The Church assigns temptations worthy to the beginning of Lent because temptations come to everybody, and we see almost genetically programmed to yield to them. We need to confront and conquer temptations as Jesus did, using the means we employ. Like Jesus, every one of us is tempted to seek sinful pleasures, easy wealth, and a position of authority, and is drawn to the use of unjust or sinful means to attain good ends. Jesus is our model of conquering temptations through prayer, penance, and the effective use of the Word of God. The first reading describes the ancient Jewish ritual of presenting first fruits and gifts to God during the harvest festival in order to thank Him for liberating His people from Egypt and for strengthening them during the years of the trials and temptations in the desert. The responsorial song points to Satan's third temptation of Jesus in the desert as recorded in Luke's Gospel. In the second reading, St. Paul warns the early Christians converted to Judaism not to yield to a constant temptation to return to the observance of God's laws. He reminds them that they will be saved by acknowledging the risen Lord Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Let us stand and pray the sinner's prayer. We stand before you, Holy Spirit,
as you gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way you have shown, and our way not to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not make us grow to soil. Do not make any hindrance be as bound on our heart. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life, and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. For all this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever.
this first Sunday of Lent, the Word of God teaches us that when faced with temptation, in order to avoid sin, we must respond with prayer, with fasting, with almsgiving, with the Word of God itself. For the times that we have failed and given in to temptation, let us ask the Lord for His loving forgiveness and for His mercy, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask you to forgive me of all the angels of this place, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord of God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "The priest shall take a basket of first fruits from your hand and set down before the altar of the Lord your God. And you shall make songs before the Lord your God. And one of the men was your father, and he went down into Egypt and sojourned there. And the Egyptians threatened us harshly, and afflicted us, and laid upon us our bondage. Then we cried to the Lord, the God of our fathers, and the Lord heard our voice, and saw our affliction, our toil, and our oppression. And the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, with great terror, with signs and wonders, and brought us into this place, and he gave us his land, a land flowing with milk and honey. And A reading from the word of faith which we preach. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For man believes with his heart and is so justified, and he confesses with his lips and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all, and bestows his riches upon all who call upon him. For everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You shall not tempt the Lord your God. and when the devil had ended giving temptation, he departed from me until an opportune time. The Gospel of the
Lord.
The act of offering the first fruits of their harvest while making
fundamental measures with God and the demands that He makes on their life and their worship, the people of God were able to avoid temptation, the temptation to forget the one who formed them into a people, for that would be their sin. To withhold their offering from the Lord would lead to idolatry. At the beginning of Lent, when we bring the first fruits of this week, the first fruits of our prayer, fasting and asking to the Lord, we find some comfort in the fact that Jesus, the Son of God and our Savior, Himself endured temptation and suffering, but He did not need to sin. The Gospel shows us how Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit to pray and fast in the desert, where alone and hungry and perhaps hungry, He faced evil head on. He faced the devil who tried to allure Him to an easy way out, a way to cause Him to forget about others, thinking only about Himself and not about the truths that He will serve and the generations that He will save. At His baptism in the Jordan, just before the temptations in the wilderness, when the heavens opened and the Spirit descended upon Him, Jesus heard the reassuring words of the Father, "You are my beloved Son." The evil one, during the temptations, by all means, tried to challenge Jesus at the core of His identity, saying to Him before each of the three great temptations, "If you are the Son of God." The temptations Jesus faced and conquered are the temptations which society presents to the children of God, making them doubt and question whether they are the beloved children of God. It is those everyday temptations, pleasure, power, privilege, sinful pleasure, to paraphrase the saying, to have my bread and eat it. Absolute power, and we see what absolute power is doing in our world here today. To possess and to control all the kingdoms of my world around me. Privilege, the privilege of entitlement, to do whatever I like, whenever I like, and whichever way I choose. These temptations, pleasure, power, privilege, when we fall into their trap, go against the lofty yet humble way of the Christian. It brings about a disconnect in our relationship with God, with neighbor, and with self. Jesus tells us that there is joy in resisting temptation, that there is sweet joy when we say no to temptation, when we say no to sin. Even though the evil one tries to disguise, to make temptation look so attractive, Jesus teaches us how to deal with temptation. For to Him, the true bread was the word of God and the word of His Father. His true power and authority was service and not domination. Jesus was not a Son man, but He would indeed throw down His life, lay down His life for the salvation of many. Through the fundamental relationship with the Blessed Trinity established for us at baptism, we become the beloved sons and daughters of God. temples of the Holy Spirit that in us, and members of Christ's body in the church, who walk together to combat evil and temptation. When we live according to this God-given identity, we are indeed able to withstand temptation. The Word of God teaches us, and especially this Lenten season, to be sober and vigilant, because your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in faith. And elsewhere, humble yourself before God, give heed to God, resist the devil like Jesus, and he will flee from you. The nearer you are to God, the nearer God will come to you. Prayer and sacrifice is the sure way to discipline our bodies, the bodies that crave, that hunger for pleasure, power, and privilege. Pray this Lent and pray sincerely. Worship and worship devoutly. Offer, give of your time, talents, and treasure, remembering that all that we have and all that we are comes from the Lord. During this Lenten season, do not negotiate with the devil. He will, as the saying goes, call us by our sin. But we must be confident in the love of the one to whom we belong, he who calls us by our names. In order to overcome temptation and so avoid sin, you must, like Jesus, fill your heart with the Word of God. And let this Word flow through your mouth and guide your actions. It is this Word, as in Paul reminded the Romans, which is near you, on your lips, and in your hearts. We who confess with the lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in the heart that God raised him from the dead, will be saved. In times of temptation, when you are in distress, call on the name of the Lord Jesus. For everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved.
Let us say our prayers of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered and was crucified, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the grave.
Fast and pray. On this First Sunday of Lent,
for the church. May we all baptized join the spiritual warfare as we battle the temptation of material greed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, yes, hear us.
We pray for world leaders. May they resist the temptation of power and glory which comes with demonic domination.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Give us the right dispositions, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings. For with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. He consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance, and by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that, celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we may pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, and without end we acclaim. Life to all things, and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, blessed Benedict Daswa, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, and Vincent our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, especially the prayers in thanksgiving for the 21st birthday of Kailash Falls. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Don Bozuko Colin Lobby, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. May we renew now with heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened. Pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment.
Call for your assistance for the sake of our peace. ministries, through your charity, we are able to feed the poor Sunday mornings through speaking, through like volunteers or at office. We say thank you for orphans and elderly. They are, there's a hospital that we have brought to recently, the marshmallows. There have been on services generally. So you get one space to find enough flower and pray for the poor, the Easter eggs and marshmallow eggs. The children have received their mite boxes and they should come back towards the end of the Lent as well. And then the same reason for society, the colors are gay. There is nothing left to give. They have given away everything and they are in need now of groceries and toiletries.
The sign will be celebrated weekly. It will be
Lent, and they are available at the back on the first come, first serve basis, and you give a donation to our community house. Let's say Father Lent, because it's even just Father Lent. The Lord is doing something back.
Anyone celebrating birthdays or anniversaries? I know it's late, but we can still pray for you. Birthdays. Some are celebrating, can I say, 40th birthdays. It's a lady up there. Adrian. Kayla today, 21 yesterday, 21st birthday. Frank and the Zed's Kayla is now 21. We must thank Kayla for her dedication. Of the youth, and even now as a young adult in our community. Let us pray. Loving God, we ask you to pour the grace of your blessing on your servants to celebrate their birthday. We ask you to protect them all the days of their lives, to keep them always faithful in your service, especially in this Lenten season, so that overcoming all temptation, they may always be in the joy of your peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I wish you all a blessed Sunday. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May bountiful blessing, O Lord, we pray, come down upon your people, that hope may grow in tribulation, virtue be strengthened in temptation, and eternal redemption be assured through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glory, Father, glory, our life.
Thanks be to God.